This is the story of two historians, one black and one white, who lived different yet amazingly parallel lives.
She got involved with all segments of Miami life. She got involved with historic preservation. She was involved with civil rights. It wasn't a thing that Arva didn't stick her toe into and succeed.
It's interesting about Dr. Fields and her work. She has made an impact across many communities and many generations.
I was born in Colored Town, Miami's Colored Town, Obertown, at the Christian Hospital, which was for colored people.
Fortunately, I grew up in a family that did not have a lot of racial prejudice, yet I grew up in a town where the races were absolutely separated.
Integration was mandated. Arva and many other women recognized the trauma that many young Afro-American students would experience. She and others set up a program where these children would have the opportunity to be prepared for the new environment.
What Dorothy did in starting the Black Archives was to include that information and to make it available to people, to have it be a living heritage that underscored what African Americans came to believe as their existence.
Dorothy and Arva both saw an urgent need to save Miami's historic records and cultural landmarks.
The Tower Theater was about to get torn down. I got involved in trying to keep them from tearing it down, not just because of my memories, but because of the memories of the Cubans who came in. They were going to lose a piece of their heritage, but many of them hadn't figured it out yet.
When the Lyric Theater was built in 1913, it rose above the rooftops of Colored Town.
When I heard that it was a black man who built the Lyric, I knew then that we could not tear it down, that he built it for us and for all of the people.
To this day, many of the buildings that she was responsible for restoring, retaining, restoring, and making them prominent has been an amazing asset for our community.
I witnessed Arva becoming a very important person. So she became a celebrity because of her writing. And she really did change the feeling of pride in Miami about our community because she wrote it down and made it all part of Miami history.
I always think it must be by design for us to have met and to be a part of this community in this way.
When you get to become a friend with a person, all the rest doesn't matter.
We have more in common than we have differences, and we should celebrate those commonalities.
Good evening, everyone. I'm thrilled to greet you this evening celebrating MCCJ's amazing milestone and to be one of the honorees for the coveted award, the Silver Medallion. The timely quote on MCCJ's website by attorney H.T. Smith states, "In times of conflict and controversy in our community, MCCJ has been a bridge over troubled waters. For 85 years, MCCJ has connected our community, embracing diversity to advance understanding and respect among all cultures, religions, and races. In the 1950s, as one of the high school students participating in MCCJ's program, I learned firsthand the lasting effect of this important organization's mission. Rooted in interfaith goodwill, MCCJ's mission includes creating safe havens for dialogue, training inclusive leaders, and highlighting the benefits of diversity. From Overtown, Reverend Edward T. Graham and Miss Marie Roberts arranged with MCCJ's then director, Dr. Max Carl, for us to participate. Pioneer participants from Booker T. Washington Senior High School included Enid Pinckney, Leomi Coleman, Maud Newbold, Beverly Nixon, Marcia Saunders, and Jewel Wilson. Decades later, I had the honor of meeting MCCJ's associates, including Dr. Nelson and Mrs. Effie Adams, David Lawrence, Leonard Turkell, Roberta Shevin, attorneys Al and Gail Dotson, Benita Whitehead, Nestor Rodriguez, and Debbie Hoffman. Thank you, Debbie, for nominating my friend, colleague, mentor, and sister of the soul, the late Arva Moore Parks McCabe, and I to receive MCCJ's Silver Medallion. Arva and I's friendship and work together recording Miami's history and telling our stories is a testament to MCCJ's mission. Different lives from different sides of the railroad tracks, our stories are recorded in the 2010 PBS WPBT documentary, Parallel Lives, which was initiated and sponsored by IWF, the International Women's Forum. MCCJ continues to seek an inclusive community in which all people are treated with dignity and respect. Thank you from both of us.